students, today we are going to perform the practical, that is practical number 2 in SDT, that is the determination of alcohol content in the Asava and Arishta. Okay, the second practical, determine the alcohol content in Asava and Arishta. So what is mean by Asava and Arishta? So Asava and Arishta are the Ayurvedic formulations. Actually there is a utilization of herbal drugs. Okay, the herbal contents are naturally fermented, and then there is addition of sugar, jaggery or honey is there. So these formulations are occurred by using the natural fermentation process. Okay, so it is called as the Asava and Arishta. So in Asava and Arishta there is a presence of alcohol, so we have to determine its alcohol content in this formulation. So for that, when you are talking about any formulation, so we have to discuss about its standardization, isn't it? Either the given drug is standardized or not. So in this, the first is the organoleptic evaluation. So first one, organoleptic evaluation. So in this organoleptic evaluation, actually this is the physical evaluation of this formulation. So in this process, what you are going to determine? So in this method, you are going to determine its taste, its odor, its color. Okay, so these are the physical parameters are discussed in the organoleptic evaluation. Okay, so by using your sense organs, you can determine its quality, and there are certain standardization process is there. So we can talk about any formulation. The color should be green or any type, that is the light green or dark green colors are there of the Ayurvedic preparation. So we are going to discuss about its color, taste, then talking about its odor, okay, texture, nature. So all are discussed in this organoleptic evaluation. The second type of the evaluation is determine its alcohol content. So for this alcohol content determination, what we are going to do? So we are going to distillate this formulation. Okay, so for that, what you are going to do? You have to take the 25 ml of formulation. Okay, by measuring cylinder, you have to weigh this formulation. Okay, and then this 25 ml, suppose this is a measuring cylinder. Okay, like this. So firstly, you have to weigh this 25 ml of formulation, and it is transferred into the distilled flask or distillation flask, more specifically distillation flask, you have to add it. Okay, so you take out the 25 ml of formulation, add it into this distillation flask. Once you add it into the distillation flask, then take 150 ml of distilled water. Change the pen. Okay, so when you take the 150 ml of this distilled water, wash this measuring cylinder by using 150 ml of distilled water, and when you wash this, then again add it into this distillation flask. Okay, now you have to incorporate the porcelain pieces into this, okay, in the distillation flask. And then it allow for distillation. Okay, it must be distillation. The process will be allowed. And once the distillation process is going to be there, so at that time what happened? You will get the distillate formulation. And in that, so suppose you will get 90 ml of distilled formulation. Okay, so you will get 90 ml. So from this 90 ml, again you have to take the 25 ml of this formulation, and add it is you have to dilute it with the are 100 ml of distilled water. Okay, what we are going, we are taking the 25 ml of formulation. Okay, then we wash that measuring cylinder, okay, by 150 ml of distilled water. Then it is again added to the distilled flask. And once you added it into the distilled flask, add the porcelain pieces into it and allow the distillation process. And once the distillation process is going on, so after that you will get approximate 90 ml of that distilled formulation. And once you get that 90 ml of distilled formulation, from that you have to take the 25 ml of distilled formulation. And again you have to dilute it. So dilute it by using the 100 ml of distilled water. Okay, once you dilute it by using the 100 ml of distilled water, again take a certain amount of or ml of that particular formulation. Suppose I will take 10 ml from this. And it should be added into the specific gravity bottle. Okay, specific gravity bottle. So by using the specific gravity bottle, you can determine its specific gravity, okay, of this formulation. Okay, and then by using the that is the relative density chart, it is given in your manual. So by using that, you can determine its alcohol content, percent alcohol content. Okay, so this is the procedure for second, determine its alcohol content. Okay, the next one is the, and how you can determine the specific gravity. So let us see specific gravity. And the specific gravity for this alcohol content is determined at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, remember this thing. And talking about the specific gravity is this such type of bottle. Okay, like this. This is the specific gravity bottle is there. So we have to use this specific gravity bottle to measure its specific gravity. So for that, what you are going to do? Firstly, take this empty specific gravity bottle, weigh this by using the weighing balance, empty. Okay, so you can call it as the W. W is the weight of empty specific gravity bottle. Then you have to incorporate essential oil into it. Suppose 10 ml essential oil, so you can calculate or call it as a W1. Okay, then after that, remove this, that is essential oil, and again fill it with the distilled water, and again weigh this, so it is W2. So you are getting the three weights, that is the W, W1, W2. So how the specific gravity is calculated? So it is calculated by W1 minus W divided by W2 minus W. Okay, so you will get this quantity or specific gravity. Like this, you can calculate the specific gravity. Next process for this determination of alcohol content is for the checking of the pH. Okay, pH, determination of pH is the fourth point of this. I will write determine pH. So for this, we require the pH meter. Okay, suppose this is the pH meter, like this, and here the formulation is, so you can incorporate the pH meter into it. So you can, here you can see the, pH of this, okay, of this formulation. So it is actually very easiest method to determine the pH by using the pH meter. Okay, it is very simple. Then the next one is the determination of loss on drying. Okay, the fifth one. So determination on loss on drying. So in this method, what we are going to do? So here we are taking the asava. Okay, asava is the formulation. It is naturally fermented. Okay, so here we are using the liquid solution of formulation. So for that, what we are going to do, firstly we have to take the china dish, okay, china dish, weigh this china dish, suppose W, then add the formulation, suppose 10 ml we are taking, so 10 ml of that solution is added, formulation is added in the china dish, so it is called as the W1, okay, and then you have to dry this in the hot air. So here the hot air oven. So at 100 or 110 degrees Celsius, we dry this, we are going to dry this sample. Okay, and once you dry this sample, so you will get the W2, that is the weight of that particular formulation. So what happened? Loss on drying is the weight difference between the initial and final. Okay, what is the loss on drying? So here suppose in the W1 it is a large number or it is high rather than this W2, because loss on drying, it is actually difference between initial and the final quantity. Okay, so here we will get this loss on, we can determine easily the loss on drying. Okay, the next method is the determination of viscosity. Okay, so I will rub this part first. So for determination, this is the last point, determination of viscosity. So here in this determination of viscosity, we are taking the viscometer, that is the Ostwald's viscometer. So it is having the two arms like this. The two arms are there. So here is the presence of bulb. The bulb 1 is there and bulb 2 is there. The second bulb is here like this. Okay. So it is a U-tube like structure. Like this. Again, I will draw like this structure. Okay, so this is the Ostwald's viscometer. Here is the marking first and marking second. So this is called as the arm first. Arm first. This is the arm second. Okay, this one. Okay, so this is the bulb first. Bulb first, or it is also called as the bulb first. Okay, there is the presence of this capillary like this. The capillary is present here. So it is a capillary. Okay. This is the upper marking, or I will write upper mark, it is denoted as A. Okay, this is the lower mark, it is denoted as B. Okay. A mark and B mark. So this is the, so now how this is working. Okay, so for this we have to take the clean Ostwald's viscometer. Okay, and then you have to add, firstly you have to place it on the stand, okay, properly. Then by using the pipette, you should incorporate the distilled water first. Okay, because the distilled water's viscosity is known to us, okay, it is a standard. So you have to take the distilled water viscosity. So firstly you have to add from this, so it will be filled like this. Okay, it will be filled up to this. Then you have to use the suction pump here. Okay, I will write here suction pump, S pump. That is the suction pump is used here. So at that time what happened, this liquid is come above the layer of this upper mark A. Okay, and once it is come here at the upper mark A, is up to this, then wait for its, when the liquid comes downstream up to this upper mark A. So as soon as this liquid or a distilled water reaches to the mark A, start the stopwatch. Okay, you have to start the stopwatch. So, and when that distilled water comes to this lower mark, that is B, stop the stopwatch. Okay, so this is the time for the distilled water, flow of this distilled water from A to B. Okay, now it is okay. Then you have to take out this all distilled water from this viscometer and add your formulation. Okay, now you have to add formulation in it. So once you added the formulation inside this, so again you have to repeat the same procedure. Okay, add the liquid in it, then you have to add the suction pump here. Okay, so it will come upstream, and when you remove this suction pump, so it will reaches up to mark A. So start the stopwatch again and wait for its B point. When it reaches to the B point, stop the stopwatch. Okay, so you will get the two readings. First one is for distilled water and second one is for this formulation. Okay, so the time required for flow of this formulation from A to B. Okay, so T1 is there and T2 is there. What is time 1? Time 1 is flow of that distilled water from A point to B point. T2, time required for flow of that formulation from A point to B point. Okay, so this is the up to the experiment, and then you have to calculate it. So how you are going to calculate it? So there is one formula, that is T1, that is the time is directly proportional. So time is where the directly proportional, it is directly proportional to viscosity. Okay, it is directly proportional to viscosity and it is inversely proportional to the driving force. Okay, it is inversely proportional to the driving force. So this is the first part, how this T, that is the time, is related to viscosity and the driving force. Driving force here going on. Okay, so like that. So here, firstly, you are getting the T1. Okay, so the T1 is equal to, this T1 is equal to, that is eta, that is the coefficient. The coefficient eta is there, like this. Okay, the symbol is given like this. So eta is there and it is inversely proportional to H rho G. H rho G. Okay. So what is mean by the H rho G? So here the H, this H stands for difference between the level, okay, of the liquid in this, okay, difference between the level of the liquid in the two phases, that is, this is the rho. Why the rho stands for? Rho stands for density. Okay, density of that particular liquid. And how the density is calculated? Density is calculated here. Okay, so as we learn by using the specific gravity bottle. Okay, so that rho stands for the density. G is the acceleration due to their gravity. Okay, acceleration due to gravity, and this N1, that is eta, this is called as the eta, it is coefficient for viscosity. So by this formula you can determine T1 and T2. Okay, and once you will get T1 and T2, you can easily calculate the specific gravity of this particular alcohol content, as well as you can determine the density of the given liquid. Okay, so how, let us see. So students, we reach towards our calculation part. So once you done the performance of viscometer, so at that time you have to prepare this type of chart. Okay, that is the table you have to prepare, that is the liquid or parameter, that is, one is the distilled water and one is for sample is or of Asava and Arista. Okay, the flow time in seconds. So in the viscometer, from reaching from the A point to B point, how much seconds you require, so you should write here in this. Okay, so you have to repeat this process for two times, for distilled water also and for sample also, and then you have to calculate the T, that is, it means the mean time of this in seconds. Okay, T is for distilled water and T is for sample. Then you have to check to determine the density of the given
liquid. So for that, what you require? You require the weight of that empty bottle. Okay, that is called as we will call it as W1. Okay, W1 is the weight of the empty bottle. Okay, then we require the weight of bottle plus distilled water, means W2, that is weight of distilled water, means the bottle which contain distilled water, that is W2. W1 is empty bottle. Okay, then we require the weight of bottle plus sample. Okay, that is W3, weight of bottle plus sample, weight of sample I will write here. Okay, that we require. So weight of liquid, so what we you will get the weight of liquid, W2 minus W1 is you will get that weight of liquid. What you will get? W2 minus W1. Okay, so in that you will get the weight of distilled water. Okay, weight of distilled water, because it contains the empty bottle plus distilled water. Now you will get complete weight of distilled water by minus or by doing the calculation, that is W2 minus W1. So you will get the exact weight of that distilled water. Okay, and same with the weight of this sample. So for that you can minus W3 minus W1. So you will get the weight of sample. Okay, and so you have to keep it in this liquid, weight of liquid. Okay, that is the sample divided by weight of distilled water, and which is multiplied with density of water. Okay, so density of water, by this calculation you will determine the density of given liquid. Okay, the given asava or ishta. So by this method you can easily determine the density of our liquid. Now we have to check the viscosity of given liquid. Okay, viscosity of given liquid. For that, what we require? For that we require viscosity of liquid is indicated by this eta. Okay, then we have to take the T1 rho 1 divided by T2 rho 2, okay, and which is multiplied by eta, okay, eta W. Okay, so what is mean by this rho 1 and rho 2? So it is density, okay, density of the given sample and density of the water, that is the at 25 degree Celsius. Okay, so firstly you have to determine the density of both water as well as the sample. Okay, then T2 and T1 is the T mean of sample, which is calculated. Okay, the second times required, that is the T1 for sample, T2 for distilled water. Okay, and it is multiplied by viscosity of water at 25 degree Celsius. Okay, this is the this is for viscosity of water. So this is the formula to calculate the viscosity of given liquid or given asava or ishta. Okay, so by this way you can calculate the parameters of the asava or arista. So we within this experiment what we do, so in this experiment we determine the alcohol content, okay, that is the asava, from the asava or arista, as well as we determine the specific gravity of that particular liquid. Then we determine the pH of that liquid, then loss of drying is there, okay, and then determination of viscosity. So this is the complete experiment number second, and you can put the value here and you will get the answer. Okay, so we will perform it. Okay,
So in the determination of alcohol content, so for that we require this asava formulation. I will take 25 ml of asava and I will transfer it to the distillation flask. So the 25 ml is taken and now I will add it to it into the distillation flask. Then we have to again take distilled water and wash this cylinder, measuring cylinder, and then it is again transferred to this distillation flask. So I wash this measuring cylinder by using the 150 ml distilled water and I added it into this distillation flask, and now I will distill it by adding the porcelain pieces. Okay, so students, actually the distillation unit is not in proper position, so I use this oxalate. Okay, in this I added the asava formulation. As I told you, by adding the 150 ml of distilled water, now the distillation is going on. Okay, the heating is going on and cooling, so I will do only one cycle of this oxalate. So the collected sample is here, so by using that sample we can determine the alcohol content of the asava. Students, for alcohol concentration, so I done the 1 to 2 cycles of this, so see the alcohol content is generated here, so I will collect it. So for checking the alcohol concentration, I distill this, distill this formulation, that is, this is the asava. Okay, now it is now I will take among this up to 25 ml. Okay, 25 ml I will take of this distilled formulation. Yes, it is 25 ml and I will dilute it by adding 100 ml of distilled water. So this is 25 ml distilled formulation. Okay, and this is the 100 ml of distilled water I will add. Okay, and once I will add it, so I will check its specific gravity by using specific gravity bottle. Okay, at 25 degrees Celsius. So this is the specific gravity bottle. I will weigh this, okay, first. So this is the specific gravity bottle and the weight of the specific gravity bottle is 140 gram. Okay, look to it, 140 gram. Okay, now I will add the distilled water in it. So I fill this 10 ml of this distilled water into it. So the now reading is of specific gravity bottle 178.55. Here I added the formulation, distilled formulation 10 ml again. So I will take reading of it. So that is 184.60. Okay, of formulation, distilled formulation. So I will take the 10 ml of this sample into the china dish. I will pre-weight this. Okay, I will weigh this weight of this china dish, okay, on the weighing balance, and then I will add this 10 ml of this formulation and I will keep it into the oven, hot air oven, at 100 to 110 degrees Celsius. Okay, and so till I get the weight second. Okay, this is the weight first, that is the empty china dish, and after drying the weight second we will get. So this is I weighted the china dish, okay, on the weighing balance, then I weighted the china dish along with this sample. Now I will keep this into the hot air oven for drying. Okay, okay, so I will switch on this.
So now it is started, and the temperature we want is 110 degree Celsius temperature. Okay, so now it is started. So let us see, after this we will get the W1, that is weight first after drying. Okay, to calculate, to determine the viscosity of this particular formulation, that is Asava or Arishta, for that what we require this viscometer, that is the Ostwald's viscometer. This is the bulb first, this is the arm first, this is the arm second. Okay, this is the bulb second is there, and here is there is a presence of capillary. Okay, see here the capillary is there. Okay, so when you put on this on the stand, so at that time when you add the certain formulation from this that is the arm first, it will enter into the bulk second, the bulk first. Okay, and when you join here at the arm second, the suction pump, at that time it will suck this to up to this. Okay, so see here the two marks are there, that is that mark first is there, and mark that is upper mark is A mark and the lower mark is the B mark. So we have to calculate the viscosity of that particular formulation. For that the flow is calculated, that is the time is calculated for the flow from A to B. Okay, and for the, so this is the actually principle of the Ostwald's viscometer, where we determine the time which is required for transfer or flow of the liquid from A to B. Okay, so let us see. For viscosity, I am taking this formulation. Okay, and this is the Ostwald's viscometer. In this, I poured from this first segment, I added this formulation. Okay, and now it is entering in this bulk. Okay, so this is the bulb first, this is the bulb second, the marking is here. So when the liquid reaches to this marking, upstream this marking, so at that time we have to wait for up to this mark, that is the A mark. Okay, and once we reach up to A mark, then we have to start the stopwatch. Okay, and once you start the stopwatch, when it is reaches to this B mark, okay, see here the B mark is there. So whenever it reaches here, so at that time we have to stop our stopwatch, and this process we have to do for two times. Okay, one is two times means two times for this formulation and two times for distilled water. Okay, so here I use this bulb, okay, for suction point of view. Now it is reached to this point, and now I started the stopwatch. So let us see. See the formulation is transferring, okay, from this point A point to B point. Now I removed this bulb, that is a suction bulb, from this. Now see the movement of the liquid or flow of the liquid. It is actually called as the U tube because it looks like a U shape. Okay, this is the bulb first and bulb second, and here is the presence of capillary. And whenever you calculate the flow of this, so there is one formula to calculate about its density or viscosity more specifically. So students, after drying in hot air oven, I will again check the weight. So see, the weight is 363.35. Okay, so it is a stable weight after the drying. Okay, so this is, and firstly we get the maximum, that is I think the 385 something the reading is there, and after that drying, that is 363. Okay. So this is the pH meter for calculation of pH in the formulation. So for that you have to take reading of distilled water first, okay, and then you have to take the reading of this formulation. So for that switch on this pH meter, okay, then add this segment into the distilled water first, take reading, and after that take the reading of this formulation.